Hey, Psych2Goers, welcome back to another video. How do you deal with stress and sadness in your life? According to Daniela Kelfer, Associate Professor of Integrative Biology at the University of California, stress plays a very important role in pushing you to optimal levels of alertness and cognitive performance. However, constantly being under high levels of stress is bad for both your body and your mind. These are six signs your psychological well-being is at risk. Number one, worrying a lot all the time. Do you feel like you're on high alert all the time? Are you over-worrying about things that you can't control? If you're worrying and fretting more than usual, chances are that your mental health is at risk. Worry that turns into anxiety can interfere with your everyday life. When your mind is under siege with worry and fear, this can affect your personal relationships, life at work, and your motivation as well. Number two, feeling guilty or worthless. Do you constantly think that you're a failure or think everything wrong that happens in your life is your fault? Feeling guilty and worthless are indicative of depression. You might have had very strict parents who had extremely high expectations, or you might have been surrounded by a group of friends who constantly made you feel bad about yourself. Such interactions can heavily affect your mental health and self-esteem. Number three, having difficulty readjusting to home or work life. Have you experienced a traumatic event and can't seem to readjust to your home or work life? Experiences such as the loss of a loved one or natural disasters can have an extremely negative impact on your psychological well-being. According to Jeremy McAllister from Hakomi Experimental Psychotherapy, experiencing traumas moves your energy levels away from their natural baselines to extremes, whether these are high or low. The reason why you have trouble readjusting after a traumatic experience is because your body has become used to these abnormal levels of energy. Number four, pulling away from people. How long has it been since you last went out with your family or friends? If you're starting to isolate yourself from others, then your psychological well-being could be at risk. You might be dealing with shame or depression and want to retract from people for a bit to process your thoughts and feelings. Taking time for self-care is perfectly okay. But if you find that you're in isolation too long, try to get back out there and see some of your friends. You might get stuck in a downward spiral if you're by yourself for too long. Number five, substance abuse. Have you recently started or increased your consumption of alcohol or drugs? This can be one of the biggest signs that your psychological well-being is at risk. When you use drugs or alcohol in excess to numb the pain and escape reality, then that is when it becomes a problem. You might think that consuming substances might make you feel better and help you cope with the problems that you're going through, but abusing drugs and alcohol can impact your mental health and it can affect your motivation levels, mood, and sense of reality in a negative way. Number six, suicidal thoughts. Have you recently started having suicidal thoughts? This is one of the main signs that your psychological well-being is at risk. Thinking about suicide is a clear indicator that you're most likely having a mental health problem. Whatever the reason for feeling like this, it's very important that you remember that there are many people out there who are willing to help you. You don't need to force yourself to handle this burden alone. Call a suicide hotline or seek help from a mental health professional if you are struggling with thoughts of suicide. Did you relate to any of these signs? Let us know in the comments below. Remember, your psychological well-being is very important and your feelings are valid. Please reach out to a mental health professional, a family member, or a friend if you feel that you're possibly struggling with any of the signs listed in this video. Please like and share this video if it helped you and you think it could help someone else too. The studies and references used are listed in the description below. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button for more Psych2Go videos, and thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.